60 seconds.
What's up, everybody? This is Moose, and this is my POV from PL Swiftwater UGC, our most recent Highlander match. First and foremost, I would like to thank Toon Squad for allowing me to record this and get it up for you guys. They were a great match partner, and best of luck to them for the rest of the season. Now, Swiftwater is a huge map. I think I went 35 kills and like 12k damage this first half. I'm only going to record this first half for now,
Mission begins in 30 seconds.
Just to give you an idea for what I did as a soldier. Now, first thing I'm going to do, my spy is telling me that they're running Uber metagun, I believe. So what I'm going to do here, I think, is I'm going to go to the window and check. Actually, no, my heavy just checked and verified. So, I'm just going to jump up on the roof. Now, my job up here is just to disallow them from using this left yard, so I'm probably going to be jumping up and down.
We're
just trying to, you know, call what's going on out on the left. Now there's spy, pop down. Now there's soldier, and their demo kind of pushed me out. You fall in the water and you're not going to take any damage, which is something to remember on this map. Now their soldier kind of got behind, but he died. There's spies in there quite clearly, and I'm just going to deny his health pack there, and he just dead ringers and gets out. But I just tell my pyro, and my pyro catches him. Now, minigun's going down. Now, I think I'm going to jump here and try to do some damage. Or no, I'm going to kill this pyro down here. And I think the engineer gets on top of him, and I just kill them both. I kind of got caught by myself over in this corner, but he's going to fall down. Now the engineer and pyro's down. I just kill them both, take out the gun. Sometimes being stuck back here isn't such a bad thing. Now I try to shoot that soldier, and he's, I think, going to escape. Oh no, I kind of denied him his jump right there, and he market gardeners me, which I have no idea how he did that, since I did well over 200 damage to him. Now, I believe both medics have held their Uber up to this point. I don't remember now. There goes Toon Squad's Uber. I think we're next to go here. Unless Clep gets dropped, which is a possibility. No, he does not. And I'm going to roll back out, I think, and take the teleporter back to the action. Now there's a spy right there, and he gets my medics, so they have pretty much taken the first point. I'm just going to stand back here now and help protect the gun for a little bit, maybe put some spam out to what's going on out there. This kind of exchange here can be kind of awkward. Just because there's not a whole lot of space for soldiers to do their thing. It's not crowded enough that you can really get good spam, but it's not open enough that you can jump around and do a lot of damage. So holding this tunnel can be kind of awkward, and I don't like it, so I'm just going to fall out. My engineer goes ahead and leaves his gun. I'm just going to go back for heals and take the top area, I believe. I saw that scout and that spy run in. I saw his... cloud, so there goes the spy underneath. I don't think I die here. I hope not, because that would be really sad. I see the scout, and I kill him. Spy completely ignored me, which is good, because I could have definitely gotten backstabbed, and that scout could have had a little bit of free reign there. Demo goes down, the medic's alone. That's nothing but a plus. Now that medic's going to be forced to kind of use some of his Uber. Without healing anyone actively, my medic gets out, leaves me alone, and I kill their heavy here, and their medic goes down. Now we have a really good hold on this point. They got a little too aggressive into us, and we were able to capitalize that on that and kill out their the people that were getting a little too crazy. And now we hold this point for a little bit longer. I'm just gonna rotate around now that I have done damage to the most immediate threats and start covering the flanks, which is my next job. Meanwhile, my medic dies because he was split from my heavy. So I'm going to go rotate to the next threat, which is going to be whatever's up on top here. Kill this soldier real quick, and then grab the health pack, probably meet up with my medic, get an overheal, and take the top. If I remember correctly, I might not here. All the while, just keeping your eyes open, there's a spy up there. He's gonna die real quick. He dead ringered out. If you looked real closely or whatever, you could see that he was still there. this spot can be pretty powerful for soldiers because you can get the first rocket in before they even round a corner as soon as you hear the door open. And if you push them out, then they're stuck. I heard a sentry out there. Someone called that the soldier was jumping in and the card was real close. So I decided I was just going to try to kill the medic. No, I didn't kill him. I just split him from his team. But their soldier kills me here, I believe. Or gets me real close and I die. Tried to deal with that cart and everyone on it. I didn't focus an enemy well enough to, do a lot of damage or get any picks. But that slowed them down enough that my team was able to get up. And we're going to hold this third point for a while, if I remember correctly. I come out, take out the gun. I was already stabbed. I didn't need to waste a rocket on it. But my job here is usually to take a heal and jump across and watch the where the gates open up over on the far side. Now, their heavy called. Their heavy was coming out, so I figured I'd help his damage out a little bit there and help him win that fight. I saw their teleporter. I saw they were going the other way, so I'm going to jump over the other way. Fail horribly at my jump. But my pyro tells me there was something up here. And I'm just going to rotate around. Don't see anything while the pyro goes the other way. Now I see that he dies to a demo man. Take the demo man out. I see a rocket coming out that way. So me and my scout rotate over this way. And he dies. And I die. Their soldier had a really good play right there. And then he got sniped. All the while, my medic's got Uber. Theirs doesn't. My sniper's actually in a really good spot for looking in that room, and now he's going to rotate back around. This was our favorite holding spot on this map, was up here. Me, my pyro, and my scout just rotated up here all the time. And just kept that alive. Now that spy was trying to distract our their Uber, and he did so pretty effectively. Their heavy's about to die, though. Since their heavy was pretty much dealt with, I went for their medic and met a pyro. Kind of a sloppy last couple plays. But it happens. This is Highlander. Everything is crazy. And you can't always get good enough comms to really make the most effect out of every single one of your plays. I come out. My job right here, I know I'm trapped. I shouldn't have come out this way. Is to distract, so I'm going to take out their sniper and distract this pyro for just a little bit. It distracts their heavy in their bed too, like they're more focused on me not picking their medic, that I just sit back here for a while and I keep them from getting too fancy on the cart. See, they're only times one that whole time. Gave my team, you know, the rest of that time to come up here and get really set up. And that's exactly what we needed. Their medic was distracted and we were able to do our thing. Now, my job right here is going to be to protect and get in on them. You see they come out in that little tiny choke area over there every once in a while. I think I'm going to utilize that a lot. Use that, how tiny that corridor is, to my advantage. Now, their spy goes down. That was kind of a lucky spam rocket. But, yeah, right now I'm just kind of rotating around. I'm going to get my heals, let my medic heal someone else. Usually as a whole soldier you have the ability to go to a health pack, which is why some of the higher level soldiers want a black box so they don't have to suck up their medic's heals. At the same time, you know, like, it's beneficial for a soldier to have 300 because he can do so much more damage. Now I see a demo made it out alive. He grabbed the health pack there. Had no idea where he was, so I checked the vents and he's sitting right here. Easy pick. Didn't see the spy until late. I probably could have helped with that, but that was my fault. I wasn't being observant. Now I see Jurati on the cart, which is pretty cool because that allows me to do like crazy damage rockets, so I miss. I didn't want to deal with that pyro. I didn't want to get reflected, so I just stayed back. Engineer takes some rockets from me. He gets out. And my medic calls that they're trying to push in from the right, so I go to help out the DPS. They get pushed back. So since they're falling out, I'm going to go ahead and kill everything else that's trying to come out. I'm on fire, I can't stick around. And almost died to that what do you call it there, that sticky there, but the demo died to a sentry, which was pretty huge. Their heavy has that skull and crossbones on, meaning that he takes like 150 damage a rocket almost. So whenever I see that, I always try to put it on a rocket or two, and it worked. Three rockets, he was dead. Their push was hampered for the next play. And here we sit, you know. Their cart hasn't really gone too far. It's still right at the top of the hill where it was when I spawned. Their demo keeps trying to bomb. Would do a little bit of damage to my med there. He freaked my med out. But it's not that big of a deal that he popped because their medic isn't even alive right now. So, I got aggressive. I tried to follow in the Uber when I respawned. Now, when you hold four, I think the respawn is like 8 seconds. When you hold five, it's like 16. So it's okay to get in suicide for a pick on four. It's not for five. Again, I just jump over here, try to do some damage. I'm gonna get forced out, and I die to the scout. Meanwhile, the cart's been rolling the whole time. They haven't been able to get to it, and that's a lot of my team as well, just denying them the cart. Their demo dies. We're looking pretty strong. Our med dies to a spy, and he was kind of upset about that. And now I have to make something happen. I see the scout on the cart. I go for him. I think I kill him. Their whole combo's just sitting like right there. I got pot shot by a sniper. I'm just gonna keep putting rockets right over there until the medic pops. And he does, so I tell my medic to get back. I'm gonna try to like bounce some of this Uber around a little bit, if that makes any sense. And try to keep the medic distracted and pulled back away from the demo. And I died. Now we're kinda weak, we're only 5 or 6 up right now, and they're all on top of the hill pushing the cart. Didn't utilize the x3 to its full advantage until just about now. Meaning that I had the ability to get up. Maybe if they pushed a little faster, I couldn't. I would have gotten backward spawn, who knows. I see them back here. No one sees me come out. I see like the whole location of their like combo. And I kill the medic. Worth it. I didn't want them having the Uber by the time they pushed in. We've already held them to 1127 over 4 points, which is really slow. Obviously, you can go a lot slower. But right now, we have to hold last. I saw something peeking in the window up top. Helped my engineer out with a spy. He called that, and I just went ahead and then rotated around. But I did call that thing out up in that window. And my spot right here for this final point is right here. It's going to be like 4 more minutes of me sitting right here killing stuff. So if you want to skip ahead 5 minutes in the match, I'm not going to blame you. We sit here and we hold. Because there's nothing else for you to do. You can't get fancy. You can't go out and overextend and get picks because it doesn't work. You have downhill advantage. You have health disadvantage. You have spawn disadvantage. And as a soldier, you are way too versatile to die, especially when you're holding hard defensively like this. Now I see the sentry shooting. I don't want to give away my location yet, unless it means a pick, so I'm not going to just spam rockets. I'm just going to sit here and wait. Now I see the cart moving. Kill the scout. The scout knows where I am now. He probably tells it to his team. Problem with that is that I'm in such a good spot that it's not really going to matter. Now my pyro on the cart dies, that's no good. I did call the spy behind the medic out and he just got away. I don't think we were too worried about it. The gun's shooting again, which means I probably have to go down and kill something. He's just going to keep trying to push the cart from that location. The sentry gun kind of has the left side of the cart there. I've got the right. And we're just, you know, there's really nothing fancy for you to do here. If your heavy dies, you might want to rotate back out and get to them. Don't get distracted by the Uber like I did, because I almost completely missed what was going on. Now my team Ubers and jumps right onto the cart, and my heavy stops, and look at that, that cart is like in, like it's two wheels over the edge, and it should be going in. If they had stood on it for another half a second, I think we would have lost right there. But luckily for us, we were up. We have Uber advantage, we have health advantage, it looks like. We're just down one, they're not. I come down here to help my heavy do immediate damage, just because I want to be right there on the cart if it starts to go. And I die, my heavy outlives me, but my heavy was getting heals that I wasn't. And I'm just going to shout out to Clef real quick. Because he's a great medic for healing me right there when I really needed it. But we held it, you know, the cart was in, and we were able to hold it there for the time being. I'm just going to take my spot back, and my medic's going to go ahead and run. Now, that mini sentry is something we haven't dealt with, and so I know now to keep an eye open for that. I see it go up again. That needs to go down. That really, like, kind of broadcast my spot more than anything else does. I'm taking an Uber right now. I don't think I even realized that I was taking an Uber until he ran in front of me. He didn't say anything. So I'm going to use that and kind of get ahead and try to do a little bit of upfront damage to slow him down. But it's not necessary. They've only got a minute left. We can hold as soon as our heavy comes up. Just to kind of give you guys an overview of what's going on. Our gear was up here. Our heavy holds kind of this area. Our pyro and our demo rotated this along with our scout pretty much the entire time. Our spy was behind them trying to go for picks. He would cloak and dagger whatever through this side of the house and get behind him. Our demo overextends in there, and I think, no, yeah, he's dead. Meaning that they were, defense is now not as strong, but it's not really going to matter here. Engineer on the car, I'm just going to stand like right on it right now and just hold from a different location. Get back up in my spot, just making sure nothing else was coming straight down. I asked my medic for heals that he can't give me because it's so close. I'm not an immediate damage class while they are. Or one that's immediately willing to go stand on the cart. And I suicide to kill that spy. And, because I didn't get a flash of the Uber. Now, I don't blame my medic for not flashing the Uber, because I need, you know, we needed to keep the Uber on the cart the entire time, and they push in who they have. They don't quite make it. I make it back up and just kind of spam rockets out, which is exactly what I needed to do. And we were able to hold them to 4 points in 11:27. So now we are going to switch to offense, and you know, first thing you usually want to do as a soldier on offense is to force a medic or take out the gun. Now, I don't remember right off the bat whether I switched to direct hit to take out the gun immediately or to just jump, and I think that decision depends entirely on the gun's location. If the gun is somewhere where you can easily see it from spawn, you just switch to direct hit and try to take it out. But I believe that they put it, like, down in this location. Just like we did. We put ours, like, right here. And we are going to, me and my demo are just going to jump straight on them. And, try to do some damage in the background there.
Mission begins in 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3.
Yeah, I see that the gun isn't up, so I'm going to switch over here. I'm going to do a double jump off this wall and just try to get behind a little bit. I get the gun location, and I die. Worth it for the intel. Their medic's sitting there. They're still strong. They haven't popped their Uber yet. I knew I wasn't going to make it to the med, so the least I could do was get the gun location for sure. Right here, I jump again. Trying to take out the gun. I didn't even know the medic was there, and he died. So the gun's hurt, and the med's down. I think I did just fine right there. And when you suicide on offense on payload, it's like a 5-second respawn. So I'm just going to go out the right again, take the roof. I think their soldier died, which my pyro failed to tell me that he killed their soldier. So I'm just going to go ahead. Their gun's down. I'm just going to push ahead, do some damage to their scout combo, distract them long enough that my spy was able to pick their medic, and their demo was behind us somehow. Still, and we check, we make sure there's no teleporter, and we move forward. Now, when you have such an advantage like that, it's you need to push forward. They were down 5. They dropped their Uber. You know, you need to stay alive. You need to push up. Do not be passive, especially on this big of a map. If you just sit around and cart jockey the entire time, they're going to get their gun up and their advantage right back up. Pyro asks for a little bit of help. He's 2 health. I don't like dealing with pyros because I'm bad at, like, tricking them out of reflex. Their demo's over there. He dies, which is huge. Her scout's gonna take some junk. I end up just cart jockeying because I needed the health. They push in an Uber and we push in behind, me and the heavy. And then I'm gonna come up here, try to find the medic and the heavy. There was no gun up there, so I wasn't able to like spam out a gun or anything. But their heavy dies. There's their medic and he dies. Play well made. We were able to push in pretty much immediately, stay real strong, and kill what was up. Now, me and my pyro are just going to spawn camp here and try to do damage so they can't get like too aggressive ahead. But it killed their soldier, and their pyro got me, but he died immediately too, which means they're 3 down for this next hold. Or 2 down for this next hold, which just makes it easier on us. The minus of pyro was pretty significant. Because they can't air blast back our Uber. Now my scout there should probably have focused this heavy instead of their med, but their med's down, I believe. And they're able to push right on through. Now I have a really sloppy play here. Someone says that the heavy's really weak, so I just turn around and deal with the heavy. It turns out he was 100 health, he's still at 100 health when I killed him, so he wasn't that weak. But we haven't quite capped here yet, but we're still, like, trying to push the cart. No one's on the cart, and our sniper should have just moved straight up and started pushing. But, he was predisposed with trying to kill stuff, and he just went and quickscoped their pyro. I can't be too upset with a dead pyro. Now, because they're pushing the cart, I'm going to push forward, and use my jumps to my advantage. Now, that soldier, killed my medic, which means I need to kill theirs. So I do. And I get behind them and just sit here, you know, like I get behind, way behind, and live somehow. I'm just gonna sit back here for a second, wait for their medic to respawn, and that's exactly what I do. He's up now. I hear their pyro, but he hasn't seen me, or she hasn't seen me. My apologies. And their medic's right there. So, I went and jumped. I didn't know that there was a gun down at the bottom that the engineer picked up immediately. I'm able to, like, juke around this engineer for a little while. I think he does eventually kill me. But, he died, I think, to my rocket there, too, which means the medic was alone. I'm gonna have to come back to my own POV here in a second, but they, bled a lot of players trying to hold this point. We were able to push right up. Okay, there I am. So, I push up, I see their soldier. Their soldier's gonna try to jump our med, and I called that well before he did. And, he died. rather, my med died. I kinda got caught by that scout there. I wasn't able to turn around and get a rocket out before I died, I don't think. And, yeah, so we're down a soldier and a medic right now, which is no good. Right now, I see their spam on the corner there. I know they're tight to that corner, so I tried spamming them out a little bit. They're holding this really well right now, but I know they're trying to hold from the cart because they don't want us to push at all. They don't want us to even get that like chance of a pushing it like our spy's going up and doing right now. So, I know they're going to hold to the cart, so if I'm going to focus spam anywhere right now, it's going to be the cart. I need ammo right now. I think I was low. and I fail a jump, which was spectacular. And I hear their charge, and then he gets dropped by our sniper, which is pretty cool. And then I sit here, I take some junk, and I die. Waste of a play. I don't think I got any picks or did any real damage, minus focusing down that cart a couple times. Now we have Uber. We finally built it up, and we're just going to cart jockey right now, which is really all we need to do. We get a sentry up, our heavies up in front of the cart. We don't even give them the chance to get close, and we push, and we took the first half off of them. My offensive round wasn't as high scoring as my defensive round, obviously, because I didn't spend a whole lot of time on the cart. Now, if you have a really, really strong scout, it's definitely worth it to have your soldier pain train on the cart and let him roam, especially on a map that's as flanky as Swiftwater, which is always an option if your scout's strong like ours is. But we had our engineer and sniper pushing the cart pretty much the entire time on offense, which allowed both me and my scout to roam. Now, otherwise, yeah, this really just kind of goes hand in hand with my upward. You want to stick and deal with the most immediate threats to your gun and your medic on defense. And then when you're done with that, then you try to put out damage, wherever your heavy demo trying to put out damage. Help them get kills or whatever, and then you want to go check the flanks. Which order you do those in depends on your strengths. If you're a really good pocket, you might want to do the first two more than the flanks. If you're a really good roamer, you'll probably be spending more time on the flanks than pocketing your medic. So it really is all about your own abilities and strengths, and you have the freedom and the flexibility to do anything you want on Swiftwater. That is it for me for right now, guys. This is Moose signing out.